of Syracuse University in Syracuse, New York. It's the site of the 1991 NCAA Lacrosse Championship as the Tigers from Towson State take on the North Carolina Tar Heels. Hello again, everyone. I'm Jim Gray, and welcome to CBS Sports' continuing coverage of the NCAA Championships. Today, we have a matchup which absolutely no one had anticipated. Everyone expected the Tar Heels to advance, being the top seed, but absolutely no one was counting on Towson State to make it this far. Joining me is Leif Elsmo, a lacrosse expert who is now covering his ninth NCAA championship. And Leif, actually what we have is a case of the high and mighty going up against a virtual unknown.
Well, Carolina, Jim, is in the middle of a dream season. They're exciting, they're fast, maybe the deepest team talent-wise to ever play the game of lacrosse. They're a true blue-chip team playing against a blue-collar team from Towson State. Now, Towson State's starting 10 is good, but it's when they go to the bench that they're going to have a lot of trouble staying with the Carolina Blue.
Now, Leif, this is the culmination of a two-week tournament. It started with 12 teams. The final four advanced here to Syracuse, and Syracuse's own Orangemen played the Tar Heels. North Carolina won 19-13, led by Dennis Goldstein, who had four goals.
Dennis Goldstein is an outstanding attackman. He leads this team in all offensive categories. He must touch the ball for that offense to be effective.
Now, since North Carolina was the top seed, they only had to win two games to get to the finals, as the 11th seed, Towson State Road, was much more difficult. They beat Virginia by a goal, then Princeton in triple overtime, then led by Glenn Smith's four goals in the semifinals, the Tigers defeated Maryland. So definitely the key for the Tigers is Smith.
Well, Glenn Smith is an exciting, dramatic shooter. He's got to get his shots today to be an impact player in this game. Look for Carolina to try to shut him off.
Leif, popularity of lacrosse is growing quite a bit. However, there are some people who are joining us today who may not be familiar with the sport.
Well, the stick is made with a hard molded plastic head. It's got a wood or aluminum handle. The soft pocket is made of mesh. It's a nylon mesh or nylon strings. And the hard rubber ball weighs about 5.5 ounces.
And let me tell you, if this ball hits you, it can really hurt because it can travel upwards of 100 miles per hour when it comes out of that stick. So it's a fast and tough game, but really not that complicated.
The playing field for a lacrosse is about the same size as a football field. The goals sit 15 yards inside each end line, allowing play behind them. Each 10-man team is comprised of three attackmen who work in the offensive half of the field, three midfielders or middies playing the entire length of the field, three defensemen, and a goalie. To keep from being offsides, a team must keep three players in the offensive zone and four players in their defensive zone. The goal measures 6 feet by 6 feet and sits in a restricted crease area. Protective equipment is relatively light, promoting the game's exciting speed. But lacrosse can be a very physical game. Defensive play allows stick checks in an attempt to dislodge the ball, and body checks are allowed on players within 5 yards of the ball. The game requires quickness and speed while paying great rewards for power, endurance, and toughness.
All right, Leif, the game is played in 4 15-minute quarters, and we're gonna have the first one, as it's Towson State against North Carolina in the NCAA lacrosse final.
The 1991 NCAA.
Welcome back to the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York. Here are today's starting lineups. First for North Carolina, they bring in a perfect 15-0 record. Their attackman, John Webster, the great Dennis Goldstein, and Steve Spears. Middies are Craig Haslinger, he'll face off today, Joe Bedell, and Dan Donnelly. Their defensemen are Alex Martin, Grahamn Harden, he's their top defenseman, and Brian Kelly. And in goal is Andy Piazza, who stopped 61% of the shots. And their rookie coach is Dave Klarman. For Towson State, with a record of 12-3, attackmen are John Blatchley, Michael DeSimone, and their all-time goal scorer, Glenn Smith. Middies are Rob Shek, David Scholl, and Doug Sheritz. And defensemen are Eric Dorn, Kyle Kernan, and Rich Regan. And in goal is Richard Bechter, a junior college All-American last year. The coach is Carl Runk in his 25th season, but he's going to have to do without All-American defenseman Carl Biernick, who's out with an ankle injury. For more on that injury and the two teams, let's bring in our sideline reporter, Dave Cohen.
Just moments ago, Carl Runk, the coach of Towson State, told me that to counteract the loss of his defenseman, Carl Biernick, he will move his long stick middie, Steve Kistler, to the close defense and put him on Dennis Goldstein and shadow the North Carolina attackman. On the other side, first-year coach Dave Klarman has reemphasized what he has said all week long. I'm not going to out-coach anybody, out-strategize people. I'll use 30 of my 32 people and try to run the opposition, Towson State, right into the carpet here in the dome.
All right, Dave, and we're about ready to get underway. Leaf, what's the most important thing in these faceoffs?
The key is to cover the ball first with your stick, thereby getting control.
And this time it's North Carolina. Here's Dan Donnelly. First shot in the goal. Dan Donnelly just 8 seconds into the game, and North Carolina's on the board.
Well, Donnelly uses explosive speed to get to the ball first, and then he freezes the defense and confuses Bechter with that same speed.
8 seconds. So North Carolina gets on the board in a hurry. They really take advantage, and we'll try it again.
And Towson State again, Jim, needs to get these faceoffs to control the tempo. They don't want to run against Carolina, but Carolina's style is to pressure the ball at all times.
That pressure pays off right here. North Carolina will take over possession.
50!
Coach Runk with some play instructions to his team. He's as surprised as anyone that they made it this far.
But of course, now that he's here, he wants to win it all. He's got a sensationally talented 10-man starting roster, and the fan base is very active too. A lot of people here from Towson State.
They made the trip up from Baltimore. Here's Rob Shek on the transition. He takes a shot. Scores! Rob Shek ties this game up at one.
Watch the defender, Busick. He never gets a chance to set up because of the speed of Shek. And then Shek bounces it beautifully behind the goalie stick right up into the corner.
Knots up the game at one here in the first quarter. And Towson State may be the 11th seed, but they certainly were not deterred after being scored upon early.
And here's a technical foul that gives possession to Carolina. Again, more pressure on the defense of Towson State.
So North Carolina will go into their set offense. Corners with a shot. Nice save by Bechter, and we have a whistle.
The whistle is for a personal foul, high hit on Cornish after the shot. Watch the save by Bechter. Not good shot selection by Cornish. He put it right in the stick of Bechter.
So now North Carolina will have a man-up advantage. They call it a power play in hockey, Leaf.
Well, the idea of the man-up at lacrosse is to spread your six players, stretch the five, and make them rotate. You'll try to work the perimeter, cutting people through the middle to find the seam.
Webster's back right! Check!
Ball comes out front to John Webster. His shot's a little bit high, but North Carolina will remain in control.
In lacrosse, on a shot, the team closest to the ball when it goes out of bounds gets possession.
Here's Eric Saraman. He scores. Great assist from Dennis Goldstein. North Carolina now has a 2-1 lead. And we'll be back with more after this. Welcome back to Syracuse. Jim Gray along with Leif Elsmo. North Carolina got a goal by Joe Bedell. Our score is now 3-1. And the Tar Heels are in their fourth championship game. They've never lost a title game. Towson State is in their first.
Of course, North Carolina winning in 1986. They've been here a lot, as you said. Towson State, you have to go way back to 1974 when they won the Division II title.
That clanging you hear is not an audio problem. That's the goalie, Andy Piazza, banging his stick against the pipe, trying to find himself in relationship to the goal.
Look, at when the ball's out front, he has the goal behind him, so he uses that stick to know exactly where he is in relation to the pipe.
Ball is taken away by Grahamn Harden, and North Carolina will come on the attack.
Grahamn Harden, excellent takeaway defenseman.
Has it this time taken away from him. Blatchley, the Smith, gets it underneath. It's now 3-2. Towson State right back in it.
This is a textbook fast break. They'll push it downfield quickly to set up a 3-on-2. The defense has to slide. Smith is the finisher.
Smith is 42nd goal on the season. He's the all-time goal scorer for Towson State.
You know, Jimmy's a senior now, but he set that scoring record as a junior.
Ball is taken away by Stuart Crotty. Advances it to DeSimone. He's tagged by Andy Piazza, the goalie, and DeSimone goes down hard. Penalty marker will take Piazza off the field.
Well, this play started with Crotty on the other end. He'll check the ball out of the stick and get the transition moving. He sees DeSimone uncovered up front. He gets the ball to him. Piazza, the only one left to play defense.
And what that means is now Billy Day will have to come in and fill in during the penalty for Piazza.
This is tremendously tough for a goalie to come in with no warm-up whatsoever and take shots at point-blank range.
No problem with that one. He deflects it nicely. Scramble in front. Shot taken by Blatchley. Again, Dave comes up big. Two unbelievable saves by Day without a warm-up. North Carolina now on the tack, shorthanded. Thomas, Acey. It's now 4-2 North Carolina. And Acey finishes a beautiful transition sequence for Carolina that started in the defensive end of the field. Here, Blatchley shooting right-handed against the perfectly positioned Day, hits him in the chest. The ball's loose. Day now scoops it up and starts that fast and dangerous transition for Carolina. Thomas attracts the defense. Acey's one-on-one with the goalie and puts it right behind him. The Tar Heels now have a two-goal lead. Last time these two teams played was back in 1989 in the first round. North Carolina won handily 19-8. The series between these two teams goes back a long way, and North Carolina has a 15-5 advantage.
The talent level, though, getting much closer here in 1991. I played at these NCAA tournaments, and I'll tell you, Jim, nothing beats being there. The experience factor weighs very heavily in North Carolina's favor.
Eric Saramet in front. His second goal of the day. Is now 5-2 North Carolina. And when you talk about experience, Saramet is a junior, and he's already playing in his third tournament.
He's got a beautiful move through the crease. He'll lose Haslinger. Watch how he cuts through the crease. Right there, losing 43 Haslinger, and all alone as he redirects that feed past the goalie.
And the Tar Heels now with a three-goal bulge. And really, it's not Richard Betcher's fault. The goalie is being shot upon at point-blank range. Really nothing he can do.
And Jim, that's what a motion offense will do to a goalie. He moves from pipe to pipe, from front to back. Very little chance to be effective.
Walker wins the faceoff. Shot no good by Smith. Towson State will take it in.
Garman doesn't like the fact that those shots are coming too close to his goalie Piazza.
However, he has to feel great about his goaltending. They've been just superb. And once again, Piazza makes a nice save.
Piazza looking very sharp on the play. Whistle for a push. The ball will go back to Towson State. But watch where they shoot against the left-handed Piazza. This is a great shot on a right-hander. With the left-handed Piazza, the stick is right there waiting.
Piazza from Oceanside, New York, one of 15 New Yorkers on this Carolina team. In fact, Leaf, nobody from North Carolina on the North Carolina team.
Getting all the great players from New York and the Baltimore area.
Doug Sheritz retrieves it. Sends it over to Scholl. Low shot saved by Piazza. North Carolina will set it up. Here's their star, Dennis Goldstein. Shot and a goal. It's now 6-2, the Tar Heels. They're on a roll. Welcome back to the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York. Jim Gray, along with Leif Elsmo and Dave Cohen. A barrage of goals to end the first period. Rob Shek put Towson State back to within three, making the score 6-3. Then Dennis Goldstein found the net, his second goal on the day. And it was a four-goal lead once again for North Carolina. And to end the first period, John Webster, beautifully behind the back. That made the score 8-3. That's where it stands right now as we're just underway in the second quarter.
Jim, the big defensive breakdowns are all right in front of Towson State goalie Bechter. They've got to check down and take away those easy shots by North Carolina.
And now Towson State must try and regroup and get back into this game. Rob Shek, that's the best way to get back into it. He scores. It's now 8-4.
All-American Rob Shek showing the great ability right-handed and left-handed. You've already seen him score right-handed. Now watch the left-handed shot about 90 miles an hour right over the head of Piazza.
And Shek already has a hat trick on the day. Dennis Goldstein leading the way for North Carolina with two goals.
Jim, they've just called a technical foul, a 30-second penalty for holding on Tim Barger of Towson State.
That's greeted with a chorus of boos from the Tiger faithful. Be a man-up advantage now, trying to add to their lead as North Carolina. Tar Heels have had it all going their way.
And Jim, North Carolina scores 41% of the time on their extra man play, and that's a very respectable number.
It's also the first time in their history, Leaf, that they've had five players score more than 20 goals. Webster, Spears, Thomas, Donnelly, and Goldstein. North Carolina patiently setting up their offense on the penalty. Webster up top. Threads the needle to Goldstein. He's got another easy one. Hat trick for Goldstein. It's now 9-4.
Watch the defender in the middle of the defense whose job it is to cut down the passing lane. He's not watching the ball. Consequently, the ball gets straight through to Goldstein for the easy shot.
And now Towson State will have a bit of a different look. Steve Kisslinger will face off.
Again, he's their best one-on-one defenseman. If he does not win the faceoff, he has the ability to take it away from the guy who does.
Steve Hooley finally comes up with it. And he just gets stripped of it by Kisslinger, just like you were saying, Leaf.
And the whistle is for a loose ball foul, a technical foul, holding possession back to Towson State.
There's Blatchley, tries to center it. That may be a case, Leaf, where these teams who are used to playing outdoors, now playing indoors in the Carrier Dome, just lost sight of the ball.
Well, when you get that ball against a background of aluminum and cement, it just doesn't stand out very well, very hard to pick it up.
And at the start of this tournament, they talked about using a colored ball, but all teams couldn't agree. Therefore, we have a white ball. Here's Dan Levy in front of the crease. He scores. And a sophomore from Baltimore has given North Carolina a 10-4 lead.
Pal Kernan, the defenseman, gets beat. Levy comes around. Watch the double team come from the right. Now Dorn has to knock Levy down. He doesn't. Easy shot.
We've talked about these two teams having to adjust to play indoors. For more, let's go down to Dave Cohen.
Carrier Dome seats 50,000 and the sight lines are excellent all over, but nobody, not even Bob Uecker, is allowed to sit in the seats behind the net. That's because the ball travels in excess of 90 miles an hour and they don't want people getting hit by errant shots. However, the aluminum seats that are unoccupied provide a difficult backdrop for the goalies against the white ball, and many goalies have trouble playing, particularly against high shots in the dome.
All right, Dave, well, maybe some of the guys should use sunglasses.
Well, Jim, that's exactly what they did in the semifinals. The Syracuse goalie, DiLorenzo, had a yellow sunglass applied to the face mask of his helmet.
Barger on the transition. Blatchley whiffs at a shot and misses an opportunity.
You can see the incredible pressure Carolina puts on the crease area, much different than Towson State's defense.
There you see Brian Kelly scoop up the ball. Now, he has a long stick, as do most defensemen. Offensive players use short sticks. Why?
The short stick allows the offensive player quickness and agility. The long stick allows the defensive player to have about a 3-foot cushion between him and the offensive player. He needs that space to be effective.
Nice ball movement. Joe Genovese is stopped from point blank range.
A tremendous save by Andy Piazza. This is one of the toughest slides for a goalie to make. Andy Piazza is focused to the goalie's right. He's on the right pipe. Now the pass goes all the way over. He slides 6 feet, but he gets his foot on the ball and flexes it wide.
Quickly on the other end, Donnie McNichol. He scores. It's now 11-4. And the Tar Heels are stomping all over Towson State.
Well, this play sums up the first half. Nobody on the defense slides. They all watch the shot by Carolina.
Come on, Ace. Fresh legs, Ace. Come on, Ace. You got fresh legs.
Towson State's really going to have to try and regroup here at halftime. And at halftime, we'll have a look at a man that many people think is the greatest lacrosse player of all time. And that ends the first half. Our score, North Carolina 11, Towson State 4. And we'll be back after this word from your local station. The NCAA lacrosse final here in Syracuse in a game that's being dominated by North Carolina. Well, whoever wins today, it'll mark the first time in 4 years that Syracuse has not won the national title. The Orangemen's efforts to three-peat were anchored by twins Paul and Gary Gate. Now, many consider Gary to be the greatest lacrosse player of all time. Now, others disagree. They say that honor belongs to another Syracuse alum. He's a man you're very familiar with, but for another reason. His name is Jim Brown, arguably the best football player who ever lived. Brown won the NFL rushing title an incredible 8 times. In his 9 professional years, he became a gridiron legend, and his Hall of Fame career is now the standard by which others are compared. But it was on this Long Island playing field in Manhasset, New York, where Jim Brown began his illustrious athletic career. And of all the sports in which Brown competed, perhaps his first love was for the game of lacrosse.
When I started to play the game, it was a lot of fun. You know, it was always a great game because like a fraternity kind of thing. And we weren't always just competing to win any championships. We just competed because it was a sport that we all enjoyed.
Brown's next step was Syracuse University. His extraordinary collegiate career was capped off with first-team All-American honors and the national scoring title.
In our senior year, we were undefeated. We had a real good team. And I remember that the first team sometimes only played about a quarter because we were that good. And then after that, we went to down to John Hopkins, down to Baltimore, and played in the All-Star game and beat the South, which was unheard of. But that senior year was like my greatest time as far as lacrosse.
A member of the Lacrosse Hall of Fame, Brown was labeled as the greatest player in the history of the sport.
You couldn't stop him. He weighed 229. He could run as fast as he had to run to get the job done. Durable, never got hurt. And he was just the greatest.
He would just run right through everybody. He would have this little tiny stick. The ball would be in there, and he could make it do tricks. He could make it talk. I mean, Jimmy was a pretty good football player, but had nothing compared to what he was as a lacrosse player.
Now living in Hollywood, California, Brown finds himself removed from a game that he still holds dear. And he is grateful that he is remembered fondly.
I feel great for the public to remember me, you know, as a fine player after all these years. You know, I mean, that's good enough for me.
And how could we ever forget? He left such an indelible impression. Jim Brown, one of the greatest athletes of all time. North Carolina leads by 7. Welcome back. Towson State trails by 7. Now, just moments ago, our Dave Cohen had a chance to talk to Coach Runk.
Carl, I know it's going to be an uphill struggle, but what do you have to do to get back in this game?
We're going to have to play a little better defense, and I think we're going to have to keep the ball on the offensive end and do a better job of shooting. We've had the opportunity to score goals, but our shots haven't really been on target. We're going to concentrate on being more aware of having good shots and doing a better job on defense.
Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Time statistics show, Leaf, that North Carolina is dominating in faceoffs and shooting percentage.
The faceoff dominance translates into more possession time, and when they get their shots, they're taking advantage of it. 42% shooting percentage for North Carolina is way above their 27% for the season. Towson State normally shoots at 31%. They're only shooting 16% today.
Now, Leaf, as we see the faceoff controlled by Towson, what has to occur for them early here in the second half to climb back into this game?
They've got to do two things right. They've got to get more shots, better shots on goal, and they've got to really tighten up the defense in front of Bechter.
Dan Donnelly out front, pulls a quick trigger, hits the side of the net. And meanwhile, away from the ball, we have a penalty.
The technical foul holding on Alex Martin, number 8. And that'll put Towson State into an extra man situation. Now in the first half, they had 4 opportunities for an extra man offensive play. They scored on 1, but on 2 other occasions, they allowed goals to North Carolina.
So now Towson will try and work around very patiently and get a good shot to try and crawl back into this game that they trail by 7. They haven't gotten a shot off with the penalty winding down. Here's Lindsey Dixon. Back out front, he winds up and scores. So just as time runs out on the penalty, Lindsey Dixon puts Towson State on the board here in the second half. It's now 11-5.
Dixon starts with the ball. He will find a beautiful passing lane against this defense. Now look at Dixon creeping in, finding the passing lane, begging for the ball. He gets it from Smith, a 10-yard hard shot, beats Piazza.
Teams have been known to rally from big deficits, Leaf, in this tournament.
The most dramatic in memory, 1983, a 7-goal deficit for Syracuse against Johns Hopkins. They came back and won the national championship 17-16.
Still a long way to go before Towson can make any claim like that. They're still just trying to climb back into the game.
Well, they started that climb offensively, but the other half is to play good, solid defense. And, of course, in the first half, the big letdown was right in front of Bechter, the crease area. They've got to check down on those easy shots by Carolina. You can see right now that they are being more aggressive defensively, keeping Carolina more on the perimeter of the offensive end of the field.
A couple of good saves by Bechter may get his confidence back.
Here's Bedell out front. Good save by Bechter. Another shot. The defenseman Haslinger steps in. What a heads-up play by the defenseman.
Towson State very lucky to get away without allowing a goal. Bedell's shot saved by Bechter point blank. Haslinger picked up the rebound, and then if it wasn't for Steve Haslinger, that's a goal for Carolina.
And the Tar Heels will bring it back. Here's Joe Bedell. Another save by Bechter.
And Haslinger takes it right out of midair. Haslinger and Bechter assuming the leadership roles in the defensive end of the field.
Here come the Tigers on the transition. DeSimone feeds Blatchley in the crease. The one bouncer. It's now 11-6, and the Tigers are clawing their way back in.
Towson State's offense starting to look like Carolina's. They use five passes on this transition to keep the defense for Carolina totally unsettled. Blatchley ends up with it, takes the shot against Piazza, who never had his feet firmly underneath him.
Just a five-goal deficit now. Cesarski has been the key. He now wins his third straight faceoff.
Towson State now winning the faceoffs and getting quality possessions and high percentage shots.
Carolina coach Klarman does not like what he's seeing, trying to change his defense and shift the momentum. Here's Doug Sheritz. He transferred from Carolina a year ago. Played as a freshman there. He shoots and scores! And he's drawn the Tigers to within four goals. It's now 11-7.
Two key moves for Sheritz in his isolation against McNichol. He starts at the right of your screen. He'll beat McNichol. Look at the backup in the middle there from the defenseman Harden. He is frozen by the fake, the hard shot to the corner. The placement of the shot is critical. You'll see the right-hander Sheritz come down. Knowing that Piazza is left-handed, he puts everything he can behind it to hit the upper left corner.
Now the Towson fans are on their feet. Trying to cheer their team back on. It's now just a four-goal deficit. And Cesarski has won his fourth straight faceoff. Blatchley, no, just left. And that could have cut it to three, but Towson will retain possession.
Towson State's transition offense is really working well. Let's see if their set offense can get back and be productive.
Smith backing his way into Blatchley in front. He scores. That's four straight goals. It's now a three-goal deficit.
The key to this goal is the slide of number 37, defenseman Harden. He comes away from Blatchley, leaving him wide open. Smith reads it, gets Blatchley the ball, and he beats Piazza.
Blatchley's on the ground being attended to by the trainers as Towson State has pulled to within three. Welcome back to the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York. Jim Gray along with Leif Elsmo and Dave Cohen. Blatchley's up. He's okay. Towson State has pulled to within three on four unanswered goals.
And look at Towson State's improved defense. Nine shots for Carolina in the first half gives them four goals. Nine shots in the second half, Towson holds them scoreless.
And Millen was just nailed by Steve Gilhooley, and we'll have a penalty on that.
Well, watch Gilhooley come from the right of your screen. He'll run right over the back of Millen. Obvious penalty there. Extra man play for Towson State.
And Steve Gilhooley will have to watch play for a minute. Extra man advantage now for Towson. A chance to record their fifth unanswered goal.
Towson State is batting 1,000 for extra man opportunities in this half. They're one goal in one attempt.
They work it around. Get it down to Smith. A low shot. It's good. Glenn Smith, his second goal of the day. It's now 11-9.
Piazza can hardly believe that Glenn Smith found the mark. Piazza left Smith little or no angle. This is the extra man play. Up top, Lindsey Dixon will drop the ball down low to Smith. Now, Smith has about a 3-inch target to shoot at, and he puts about a 90-mile-an-hour shot between the ankles of Piazza.
So that's now five unanswered goals by the Tigers. They've drawn to within two. Yesterday, when we spoke to Coach Carl Runk, he told us that watching his team is like watching a car accident. They're just all over the place, and really what we have is organized chaos right now by the Tigers. In fact, Leif, really, if his team was a car, they were badly dented in the first half. Now they're in the showroom here in the second half.
Well, he's got him running great right now, running on all eight cylinders. The question is, will they run out of gas?
Well, as we look forward to the fourth quarter, that's a very good question, Leaf, because North Carolina has much more depth, and during the regular season, they have outscored their opponents in the fourth quarter by a margin of 3-1.
And Towson State's lowest output in scoring is the fourth quarter.
Right now, the Tar Heels just want to stop the bleeding. Five straight goals. Steve Spears in front. Well, he did just that. It's now 12-9.
The key to this shot is the defense leaving early. The man for Carolina will be open to the right because the defender leaves early. He turns and fires it over Betcher's shoulder.
So Dave Klarman can breathe just a little bit easier. He's in his rookie season, taking over for Willie Scroggs, who served Carolina for 12 years. Klarman's trying to become the first rookie head coach since 1984 to win a championship, and it was Don Zimmerman who did it with Johns Hopkins back then. Great save by Bechter.
Towson State does not want this lead to get any more than three goals. When you're within three, you feel like you've got a shot. Four or more, and you feel like the game is slipping away.
And it stays within three on another great stop by Bechter.
Bechter has done a wonderful job of cutting down the angle. Here he steps up and looks that shot right in the face. On the following shot, he comes toward the shooter about 8 feet and cuts the angle down before making the save.
So as time winds down here in the third quarter, it's been a great comeback by Towson State as they put themselves back into the game. Sherritt shoots a little bit high. The Tigers will inbound once again. Settles it again to Sherritt. Another shot by Sherritt. Nice deflection by Piazza.
Most of these shots high into the opposite side of the left-hander Piazza stick.
Glenn Smith, the turnaround jumper, finds the back of the net.
And that's two shots in a row that Smith has threaded the needle. They caught the five hole right between the legs of the goalie. He drives in, fakes he's going for the left-hander, wheels for the right-handed shot, and right between the legs of Piazza.
Smith now has a hat trick on the day. It's 12-10.
Well, Smith and Blatchley have really answered the call by their coach. They were non-existent in the first half. They've come on strong in the third quarter.
10 seconds left in the quarter. Big pileup. And Towson State will have the final shot. To Smith again. He hit the pipe. Oh! He could have drawn him to within one. There's a penalty marker. It'll be assessed against Carolina at the start of the fourth period. The Tigers have roared back and trail by two. The fans of Towson State are up on their feet, cheering on their Tigers, who've rallied from a 7-goal deficit in the first half. They trail now just by two after scoring 6 goals in the third period to just 1 for North Carolina. Play just underway here in the fourth quarter. Jim Gray along with Leif Elsmo.
This is Blatchley against Harden, the defenseman. Harden has owned this matchup all game long.
Here's Blatchley out in front, working on Harden. Slips and falls, but scores on the way down. It's now 12-11.
Blatchley is normally a feeder. He gets most of his numbers from the feeding position, but the aggressive defense of Harden does not let him get a feed off. He waits for Harden to overcommit to the right, and then he rolls to the left, almost losing the ball, and as he falls down, he goes high and hard to beat Piazza. From behind the goal, look at the small target now as Blatchley comes around over the right shoulder of Piazza. That's the target that Blatchley hits, away from the stick of the goalie.
The chance continue for Towson. They've now pulled back to within one. Really just a marvelous story, regardless of the outcome. The number 11 seed, down by 7 goals at halftime, rallying and putting themselves in a position to tie and possibly win this game.
Towson State has done a great job of showcasing their top 13 players, who are as good as anybody in the country.
Here's Tony Millen, a chance to tie, stripped away beautifully by Brooks Matthews.
Matthews did a great job with the long stick. Watch, he's playing defense on Millen from behind. The long stick comes out, and at the last moment, checks down on the pass.
North Carolina working back on offense into a set play. Very patiently, they'll look for a good shot. And we have a whistle.
The whistle is on Kyle Kernan, number 7, the defenseman for Towson State, as he slashed number 15, John Webster of North Carolina. So he will now serve a 1-minute penalty, getting some words of encouragement from his coach, Carl Runk, obviously pleased with his aggressive play. And Leaf, they're now up by 1 goal with the ball. How much will experience be a factor in this situation as we wind down in this game?
There's no question experience matters greatly, but maybe more than that, the depth of the roster. Right here is where the deep roster for Carolina really starts taking its toll on Towson State.
They work it around. Michael Thomas shoots behind the net. They'll retain possession.
Carolina cutting a lot of players through the crease. That's where they like to get the ball in close to the goalie for a high percentage shot.
Clock winding down on the penalty. It's at 20. Here's Spears over the middle. Saruman shoots high and scores over the outstretched stick of Bechter. And North Carolina once again has a 2-goal lead.
Saruman finally gets some room inside. You can't fault the defense here. Watch the slide come hard. But Saruman, as he's getting pushed back, shoots over the head of the 5'8" goalie Bechter.
So the man advantage works out for North Carolina. Saruman on his 3rd goal of the day. Mad scramble at the faceoff. Finally, it's controlled by Steve Gilhooley. And he pulls the trigger. Nice save by Bechter. Oh, and Towson State could have controlled possession, but they let that one get away.
Rich Regan was fighting for it for the Tigers, but double-teamed by the Carolina pressure.
Here's Mike Thomas. Comes across the crease. Nice save by Bechter. Moves it forward to Shek.
Haven't heard much from Rob Shek lately. He dominated the first quarter.
Here's Doug Sheretz bringing it down. Nice deke. Shot and a goal! Doug Sheretz, the transfer, has taken his new school and pulled them to within 1 goal of his old school.
Towson State now has to continue to control the tempo. The faceoffs are all important. Towson State must slow things down as they have throughout the second half. Carolina has to take advantage of their depth. They must push the tempo, create more transition, and use the extra legs they have.
And if they don't begin to use those extra bodies and extra legs, they could be on the wrong end of one of the greatest upsets in NCAA lacrosse history. North Carolina clinging to a skinny 1-goal lead. Goldstein out to Bedell.
Defenders on this shot. Instead of blocking it down, they both duck. Millen and Regan will duck on this shot as it finds the corner above Bechter.
And Leaf, could this be the first signs of fatigue? Because usually those guys have been putting their bodies on the line, and they have done so all game up until now.
There's no question that this is the part of the fourth quarter that worries Carl Runk the most.
And no one knows better how to take time off a clock than the University of North Carolina. They've all been watching Dean Smith in that four-corner offense, and this is lacrosse's version right here.
But just like basketball, Jim, if they get an easy shot, they're going to take it.
And Ryan Wade spots an opening, and that's all he needs. North Carolina leads by 3, 15-12.
Watch the right part of the screen. Defender Haslinger gets caught on that pick, and that gives Ryan Wade enough room to take the hard left-handed shot.
So Carolina continues to show a tremendous amount of resilience. They lead it by 3. Back in Syracuse for the NCAA Lacrosse Championships, and Leaf, North Carolina, has just added a couple of goals.
Well, Michael Thomas scores the first one. More of that motion offense for Carolina. He beats a leg-weary defenseman, Kernan, and just bounces it past Bechter. The second goal is by John Webster. He'll drop the stick low, bringing Bechter down a little bit, and then shoots high over his shoulder.
So now down 17-12, frustration is starting to set in for the Tigers. Just moments ago, Steve Haslinger popped goalie Andy Piazza in the head. And he is now off serving a penalty, of which there is 40 seconds left. So it's a man-up advantage for North Carolina.
And very tough for Towson State to go out and double-team to get the ball, which they would do if it was 6-on-6.
Goldstein down low. Shot hits the back of the net.
North Carolina retains possession on the man up. Here's Thomas, rejected. Goldstein on the rebound. And that ought to do it as the Tar Heels have once again built up a 6-goal lead.
And this late in the game, too much to ask for Towson State.
The celebration has begun over on the Carolina sidelines. They know it now. The title will return. It hasn't been there since 1986, but this will be their fourth title in 10 years. There's a shot by Tony Millen, and that goal will make the score respectable for Towson State. But with just seconds remaining, North Carolina is about to join Division III champions Hobart College and the women's champions from the University of Virginia as this year's lacrosse elite. And Leaf, as the clock winds down, the final score really won't indicate just how good a game this really was.
And this undefeated team from Carolina will be remembered as one of the deepest, most talented teams ever to play the game of lacrosse.
The title returns to Carolina. Let's go down to the field to Dave Cohen, who's with Coach Klarman.
In the second half, did you have the anxious moments when they made that great run and came within one at 12-11?
Of course I had anxious moments. They're a very talented team. Towson State, they belong here. There's no doubt about it. Anybody who watches the game knows that's a great team out there. They really are.
What did your team do to regain the momentum and get back on top?
They probably just dug a little deeper. You know, we got some nice ground balls, some clutch goals from a few guys. That's how we played all year. We are not and never have been a dominating team. We just have a lot of guys. I think towards the end, when we play a lot of people, and you have legs, you win the game.
Congratulations.
So really what this game boiled down to was a tale of two halves, and Towson State just dug themselves too big a hole, Leaf.
They took themselves out of the game in the first half. They put themselves back in the game in the second half. And then, when it came down to who had the energy left, it was just too much to ask for the Towson State Tigers.
And North Carolina also had too much depth. So once again, the final score, North Carolina 18, Towson State 13. For Leaf Elsmo and Dave Cohen, I'm Jim Gray, saying so long from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York, where North Carolina has captured the 1991 NCAA Lacrosse Championship. Coming up next, it's the Kemper Open from the Tournament Players Club at Avenel in Potomac, Maryland.
The 1991 NCAA Men's Lacrosse Championships has been sponsored by Honda, maker of fine quality automobiles. Test drive a Honda at your local dealer today. Old Spice fragrance and aftershave, cool, crisp, and unmistakably masculine. Old Spice. And by the Upjohn Company, if you're concerned about hair loss, see your doctor.